Hi babes, welcome back to Bibliophile ASMR. It's your girl, and welcome to today's, well not today's first, but the channel's first coffee in the morning commute. I think I'm gonna call it coffee commute. School coffee commute. I gotta come up with a name for it, but today's sponsor is our fave, Cheryl. Cheryl, thank you so much for being today's sponsor. This is my basic girl today. I think they got it right, yeah. Because, girl, I messed up ordering it. I was like, hi, I'll get the vanilla cream cold brew. And then I was like, wait, actually, I fucked it up. No, but no, it's right. She's like, we'll fix it when you get up here. But it still says vanilla cream on it. Okay, so something I'm going to talk about with this new series. So I actually have gotten a lot of people who are excited to sponsor. So I've got, I think, like 7 videos right now that are sponsored. Today's number 1 of 7. And I'm really excited about this. This is going to be something I can look forward to. I think I'm going to do it every Tuesday and Thursday, depending on if I have like classes I have to go in or not. It might switch, but for right now, it's going to be Tuesdays and Thursdays. But what I need help with is my lovely babes who are going to sponsor the videos. I need some suggestions or tips on what you would like the video to be about. So, Miss Cheryl, obviously, you're our guinea pig for today. But Cheryl, if you want to DM me on Instagram with some suggestions for your next 3 videos, let me know. Otherwise, I'm just going to ramble. But, like, if you want me to talk about, like, stories about my childhood or like specific things, like different, like I could talk about different parts of school or things I've learned in life or whatever, like we could do different ages of my life. I'm like, what do y'all want to get to know? Like, what do y'all want to know? Like, what's the tea? So today we've got nothing but me talking about my life. So what have I got going on this week? So I have a quiz this morning, and I think that we're going to go over that when I get to school in just a little bit, just like run through it. It's the note template quiz. So this is, the note template is for medical notes that we take going from the patient's name all the way to what we're going to diagnose them with and how we're going to treat them. Today we are being quizzed on the template of this. Of course, I've done this before. This is my second time in this class, so I already am very well versed with the template, but you know, it's always good to go over things. My dad tells me how nervous he is that I'm doing this while driving, but I gotta tell you, I'm a great driver and I don't really look at the camera. So I have a quiz today. Screenings and dental and vision and other, you know, so unfortunate. What else? I have a video with my best friend, Jenna, about the part two to my Meet My Friends series. I was going to, let's see if I can get around this semi. Stroke there, blocking off. to stay up until 3, which is so annoying. I could be home right now. So let's talk about the medical note. Okay, so the medical note, we're going to start with the patient's name, the patient's date of birth, the date of service, like the date of the encounter, and the time. And then we start with their chief complaint. So I like to do the chief complaint in the patient's words. So if they say, my head hurts, I'm not going to say headache. I'm going to say, quote, my head hurts. Because, you know, you perceive things differently than what the, you know, patient perceives. Not a classmate. Okay. After the chief complaint, we talk about the HPI, or the history of present illness. This is going to be in paragraph format with each issue, complaint, slash chronic illness getting its own paragraph. And within each paragraph, you're going to have OPQRST, which is how we describe the complaint. We have pertinent positives and negatives, which are review systems or symptoms associated with it. Then we have related diagnoses, workups, and interventions slash treatments. And then we have risk factors. My brother had me sign up for this. He got this like smart scale, and now it's giving me suggestions. Pardon me. Someone's flying in over there. Okay, so each paragraph will have that. Then after we're done with the HPI, we move on to the actual review of systems. So the review of systems is 17 systems that we go through in order from top to bottom, starting with general. Then we do head. Then we do EENT. Then we do neck, cardiac, respiratory, breasts, GI, urinary, genital, vascular, hematologic, endocrine, neurologic, musculoskeletal, psychiatric, and skin. So that's that. Then, who is that? Why do I know her? Then we have, after the review of systems, we move on to your past medical history. So I want to know your diagnoses, when you were diagnosed, like the date. And I usually do that in some sort of order, you know, either from the most recent diagnosis to the, first diagnosis you ever had. Then we do past surgical history, again, in some sort of order. I want to know what surgery or procedure you've had. I want to know when you had it and any complications you've had with it. Then after past surgical history, we have medications. I want to know what medications you're on, the name of them, the dosing slash strength, the route, the frequency, and your compliance with it. And I also want to know any over-the-counter herbs, supplements, or vitamins you may be taking. Then we move on to allergies. I want to know what allergies you have, what you reacted to, and what the reaction was, and when you had that reaction. Then we move on to family history. So family history, I want to know what the relation of the person is. I want to know how old they are, if they're alive or dead, what chronic illnesses they had, and if they died, what their cause of death was. We usually do mom, dad, brothers or sisters, if you have them, children, if you have them, and grandparents, if you know them. Then we do social history. So social history is can be in paragraph format, but I do it in list format. So with this one, we ask marital status, we ask your support system, your occupational status, any illicit drug use, alcohol use, tobacco use. I want to know your diet. I want to know your caffeine consumption. I want to know your exercise or your activity level. Then I want to know any stress or anxiety you have in your life. And then I want to know sexual orientation as well as sexual activity and if you're using protection. Then we move on to health maintenance. Health maintenance, as we said, is immunizations. Immunizations, screenings. My friend's is the objective portion of the medical note. So with this, we're going to do, from head to toe, we do vitals. No, it's too dark. Vitals, general, H-E-E-N-T, neck, cardiac, respiratory, breasts, abdominal, genitals, extremities, neurologic, psychiatric, and skin. Then we do, after a physical exam, then we do the A&P, which is the assessment and plan. So this is where we're going to diagnose you. And the diagnoses are in order from most to least important or most to least acute / critical. So, it's so bright. So let's say we're going to just put diagnosis one. Then we're going to give a very brief rationale of why we think you have this diagnosis. Then we are going to document that we educated you on it and what we educated.